Christ. In 1 Kings, the Old Testament, in 1 Kings chapter 2, there is an extraordinary and interesting incident when Bathsheba, King Solomon's mother, went to meet him. On seeing his mother, King Solomon gets up from the throne, goes to receive her, and brought another throne for king's mother and made her to sit on the throne. Then Bathsheba, mother of King Solomon, made a request to the king on behalf of Adonijah, half-brother of King Solomon, which was granted promptly, wholeheartedly, and with overwhelming joy, as King Solomon was delighted and excited by the visit of his mother. At the wedding feast of Cana, Jesus Christ is honoring his mother, Mother Mary, in a very candid style and paying respects in highly commendable manner. On this occasion, Jesus calls his mother woman. In the creation accounts, in the Old Testament, Eve is called woman more often than she is called Eve. So in the wedding at Cana, the name clearly harkens back Eve. By calling her woman, Jesus is confirming for us that she really is the new Eve, his counterpart as the new Adam. Jesus called her woman not to insult her, nor degrade her, but to confer on her the responsibility of the woman of the New Testament, the new Eve. And she becomes mother of new generation, new Israel, and the new covenant. And indeed, it is a fabulous compliment. Mary is born to receive honor, respect, and veneration. Whenever we are honoring Mother Mary, we are honoring Jesus. All glory goes to Jesus, our Savior, our Redeemer. The joy of celebrating nuptial relationship with God. In Israel, wedding or a marriage was the celebration of joy, as it reminds the special relationship of Yahweh with Israel as his spouse. Yahweh was considered or portrayed as bridegroom. This reflects the union of God and his community or covenantal love in mystical marriage. From this, it is clearly inferred that the joy of mystical marriage is nurtured as Jesus, Mother Mary, and disciples participate in the celebration of this auspicious event. The situation or the context of reciprocating filial love of Jesus towards his beloved mother Mary is clearly and magnificently visible at the wedding feast of Cana. Serving wine at the marriage party is zenith of celebration of nuptial relationship with God. That is why Jesus at the Last Supper changed wine into blood of Jesus Christ. At the wedding feast, water he changed into wine. At the Last Supper, wine he changed into blood of Jesus Christ. Mother Mary says, they have no wine. At this juncture, Mary, having realized that there is shortage of wine, reports to Jesus about it, and she takes decision and instructs the attendants to do what he tells. It is Mother Mary who is playing a decisive role here in this episode of the Gospel. Wine is a sign of happiness, love, and plenitude, and that many families today have also run out of wine due to loneliness, unemployment, illness, or discouragement, frustration, or any other difficulties. Mary, an attentive and concerned mother, shuns self-centeredness to realize when others no longer have wine in their lives. Hence, she is altruistic. She is going out of the way to help the people who are in need. Today, she will help you. She will assist you. She will do anything for you if you are faithful, loyal to Jesus. She presumes or takes for granted that Jesus would oblige her without any hesitation. Here comes the positive response of Jesus and the way he honors her. So at the cross, this mystical love of marriage is established by Jesus Christ in the new covenant, and that is how St. Paul compares the church and marriage, as Jesus Christ is a bridegroom and the church as the bride, in Ephesians chapter 5. Mary is born to be mother of the sacrament of marriage in the Catholic Church. Response of Jesus. Jesus' answer startled Mary, baffled her. When Jesus said, "My hour has not yet come," as it implies the crucifixion, he was intending that a miracle worked as a sign of his divinity would be the beginning of his death on the cross. At the desert, after 40 days of fasting, the temptation of Jesus by the devil was to prevent him going to the cross. The devil tried his best to stop him to go to the cross, to go to the Calvary. The devil tells him to use his spectacular powers and achieve glory and honor easily without going to the cross, without excruciating pain. But on the contrary, in this event, Mother Mary, being aware of the mission of Jesus, here she insists Jesus to inaugurate the hour of the hour, to inaugurate the way to cross by changing water into wine. Satan tempted him from death. Mary appeals him to take up the path of cross. This shows that Mother Mary is born to be a mediatrix for all who are seeking the fullness of joy, and born to be intercessor for all those who seek her help and her assistance. Jesus obediently complies his mother's request by honoring and performing the first miracle. He performed the miracle to reveal his glory so that his disciples will believe in him. The first miracle was something like the creation itself. It was done by the power of the word. The first creation, the book of Genesis, was by the word of God. So also, by the word of Jesus Christ, the water is changed into wine. And finally, the finest wine is yet to be tasted. To those who are experiencing difficulties, to those on the outskirts of society, to those that feel that all their jaws have been broken, Jesus pours out the best wine. At the request of Mother Mary, at the intercession of Mother Mary, there was best possible wine for the wedding party. Not only for the wedding party, for each and every one of us who venerate Mother Mary, there will be best wine for all of you. Best wine yet to come, and the hour of best wine is today. Today onwards, you will experience fabulous, amazing, and outstanding blessings from Mother Mary, which is called best wine for each and every one of you. Jesus is the best wine. Mary is the best wine. This shrine and this parish is the best wine. Every married couple is the best wine. Every believer in Jesus is the best wine. And finally, everyone who honors Mother Mary is the best wine. You are the best wine. Let us thank the Lord for this gift as we celebrate the Nativity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who has made us a best wine, a best people of the new covenant.